Thank you, Mr. Lauffer. I think your speech might be longer than mine. But first and foremost, I'd like to thank Ms. Caskins for choosing a venue with adequate air conditioning. It's a luxury that most of us don't really know at Bethune. My name is Wenson Yen, and I am your valedictorian. I read the morning announcements. My favorite subject is math, thanks to Mr. Jessup somewhere up there. And as Vice President of the Student Council, I've had the privilege to represent the voice of the student body for the last year. I'm honored to be standing up here on stage today and have the opportunity as valedictorian to represent this brilliant class one last time. So, for the last time I'll be able to say this. Good afternoon, Bethune. Today is June 29th, and here is your commencement address. I'd like to start off by welcoming guests, staff, parents, and debatably the most important group in the house, graduating students. We gather around here today to celebrate the academic achievement of the 2016 to 2017 graduating class of Bethune, to acknowledge the hard work, persistence that the students in this room have endured over the last 4 years. The countless hours using Desmos and Photomath to find the derivative of a logarithmic equation, endless questions we asked our parents to do our family tree summatives, and the 2 a.m. caffeine intakes when we were doing our English essay that was due, you know, the next day, that we were given a month to complete. Unless you took private school English. Now, Dr. Norman Bethune is a very unique high school. And by that, I mean it's one of the few high schools in the TDSB that still does not have Wi-Fi. But in all seriousness, Bethune brings one word to me, and that word is opportunity. Where the only limitation to what is within a student's grasp is set by the individual. Having more clubs than the number of students, if there's an interest a student wants to pursue, then there's a club that caters to that interest. The absurdly high number of clubs comes with good reason, though. Because what populates this school is a student body with so much passion and students that want to partake in everything. We have a student body that comprises of so much drive and motivation that administration had to set restrictions on how many clubs you could be an executive for. Now, like I said, the word Bethune refers to nothing more than just a building. A big brown building on Fundy Bay Boulevard that congests the neighborhood roads every morning, as we've all heard. But it's not about the morning traffic, the awful acoustics in the commons, or how there are secret washrooms in the G-Wing. But the people within this building that make Bethune so unique. The staff, the members, our rock star custodian, and of course, Mr. Brown and his shiny bald head. These individuals are what bring this school to life. And to my teachers, could I please have all the teachers stand up? Please. I see you up there, you gotta stand up too. On behalf of my graduating class, I would like to thank you for all that you've done for us within the last 4 years. We as students came into this school as young and naive individuals, and the impact you have left on us as educators on this journey of adolescence is one that we will carry for the rest of our lives. Now you see, the teachers at Bethune have a very symbiotic relationship with students. These are individuals that care about their students on a level that goes beyond their job. The mutual respect is reciprocated by the students and what makes this relationship so dynamic. From waking up early to arrive to school for 7 a.m. volleyball practice, to staying until 6 p.m. after school to conduct the wind ensemble, to taking an entire week away from family to be with students at DECA's international competition thousands of kilometers away in California. The countless hours that these staff have taken out of their own lives to support students' extracurricular activities demonstrates the level of dedication within the staff have for students. The teachers at the student have given students the opportunity to be anything they want, pushing students beyond their limits to uncover their true potential. More than just teachers, but mentors guiding us through the toughest times with their years of wisdom. And now what I can say for certain is that the most prominent memories I will have with my teachers is not learning how to apply calculus formulas or learning about organic chemistry, but the life lessons that were intertwined into your lectures. It's the conversations that I've had with my teachers completely unrelated to chemistry or physics that I will remember for the rest of my life. And yes, Mike, I'm talking about you and your million stories about your children. So today we have a couple graduating staff members too. And by graduating, I mean retiring. So Mr. Sylvester and Mr. Brown, two of the most involved staff members I've had the pleasure of working with. First off, Mr. Sylvester, you've contributed tremendous amounts of time towards our music program. A music program that is known throughout the city for its excellence. And in the short 3 years you were at Bethune, you have pushed the limits of the school's already excellent and renowned music education. And Mr. Brown, you're one of the most genuine teachers I know. And perhaps you have the most interesting stories I've ever heard. Your dedication, your work done towards the business program is one that has shaped future entrepreneurs, chartered professional accountants, and more. The smile that you leave with students is one that cannot be replicated. Always welcoming and always understanding, you always make the business office and B207 welcoming to visit. And just as the students graduating here today, both of you will be starting a new chapter in your lives. Hopefully one where one of you is sitting in a beach in Jamaica enjoying the sun, and the other one is exploring Europe's finest wines. I wish you two the best. Now, although we stand here today to celebrate the students, there are figures in this room that deserve more recognition than given. Parents and guardians, you are the backbone of the students in this room and the success they've achieved today. Taking a good look around the room, it is safe to say that the parents, a majority of the class has parents who are immigrants, parents who come from China, India, Greece, Vietnam, and various other far reaches of the world with one common goal, the hope that their children will live a prosperous life with good education, good healthcare, and find overall success. To provide their children with more opportunity than was given to them, knowing that all their hard work would pay off one day. Now I'd like to tell a story about my father, sitting somewhere in the crowd where I can't find himself. Unfortunately, my father was sent to Canada by the Chinese government from the Foreign Trade Department to do business. Selling vases and antiques, he had a stable job in an impoverished country. Making well over the average wage at the time, this was a country where the opportunities that we take for granted were rare and hard to come by. Where there is no direct correlation between working hard and the quality of life. But in the short time working abroad, my father fell in love with this country. So much in fact that he gave away everything he had to build a new life in Canada. Coming to this country as an immigrant, he had nothing. No money, no home, no certainty. He worked various minimum wage jobs at warehouses and factories just to make ends meet. But in his eyes, it was worth it. Not because life was easier in this country, because it wasn't, but for the opportunity that this country provided. Now to all immigrant parents in this room, words cannot describe how grateful we are for your work. I'm sure if immigrant parents were born in our generation and they listened to Drake, they'd be singing, "Started from the bottom, now we're here." As they truly did start from the bottom, working long, hard hours to save for their children's education fund from the day they're born, driving countless trips every week to drop off their kids at piano lessons, after school tutors, after school sports, and of course, buying all 6 series, the summer coupon practice books that we love doing instead of going outside. So parents, you've given us the greatest gift possible. Not a physical gift, but the gift of opportunity. The chance to truly let us be who we ought to be. And like not just an engineer, accountant, lawyer. Or of course, who could forget the infamous doctor. Now, I'm gonna go off script a little bit, but I want to talk about Arnold Chan today. Arnold Chan really touched me when he was giving a speech, and I want to talk about the impact he's made on my life. When I was 13, I went to a sushi buffet, and I was invited because of the fact that there was free sushi, I wanted to go, and it was to support the community. I met Arnold Chan there, and he was, I think, running for a position I don't remember, I was really young, but he came up to me, and he said, He started talking about his values and what he stands for, and he asked me if I was going to vote. I don't know if he knew I was 13 at the time, but I was not allowed to vote, and then I told him that, and he said, you know what, you'll get there one day. You know, work hard, and you'll make whatever, you become whoever you want to be. And it didn't mean much to me back then, but now that I look at it, Arnold Chan is one of my biggest role models I have in life. Seeing him every day on the news, battling what he's going through in life, and still doing what he loves, is truly inspiration to me. Continuing to preserve what he believes in his time of perhaps not the best time in his life, he has really motivated me and inspired me to become who I am today. Now, to graduates, I want to say thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to represent you at this pivotal turning point in our lives. Every single one of you have made a mark in this school, and you all make a unique aspect of this wonderful community. And I want to thank you for creating this truly once-in-a-lifetime experience. Now, students, I'd like you to look around the room and think of someone around this room who's made an impact in your life.
You did!
It might be someone you were on the light bulb team with, or someone you had AP chemistry class with, or simply someone you see walking down the hall. But I want you to think of the impression that they left on you, and think of the impression you might have left on them. 10 years down the road, I want you to remember your peers and their effect on you. Not only the math mark or the chemistry mark, but the people that make this school exceptional. A group of people that we all belong to. And our future alumni, this feeling that you're feeling right now, whether it be the feeling of invincibility and the eagerness to take on the world, or the hangover from last night, I want you to know that we've had a good run. Because if high school is meant to be the most memorable 4 years of our life, then I'm glad we were able to spend it together. Because today, we are the same. Despite where you come from or where you're going, today we wear the same caps, the same gowns, and we receive the same diplomas. We are filled with the same hope, and we look into a future of uncertainty. We all have our own bumps and bruises from our journey, and the slightest hint of wisdom came from them. But whether we choose to pursue a college or university education, or are taking a year off to find ourselves, we all made it. Now, though our past may not be the same, we are equal in the sense that there is limitless opportunity ahead of us. And just as we all remember grade 9 orientation as yesterday, or how grade 12 year was just beginning, these 4 years went by faster than we thought. But what makes time valuable is that it doesn't last forever. What makes time precious that it ends. Time is fleeting, and just as fast as today came, it will be gone into another memory. For the last 14 years up until today, we all followed a pre-designated education system, with each year logically leading to the next. But now we stand at the end of our chapter. Today marks the beginning of our own individual journey, to live a life that is solely our own. The decisions that we will make will determine who we become. So promise yourself, promise me, that you will embrace the fortunes that are laid upon us. Cherish the opportunities that we have in this society. Become the best version of yourself. Find your ambitions and follow them till the ends of earth. Because even if we fall short of our dreams, what better way is there to live?
Thank you for Wenson. Wenson, Wenson, Wenson! No, it's okay, but Ms. Caskins, could you please come forward and present the Dr. Norm Bethune Valedictorian Award on behalf of the graduating class of 2017 to your...